I don't have the budget yet to hire a graphic designer. Are there any free graphic design software that I can use to help me get started? Hey, good day folks, I'm André Givogue, your friendly host here for CareerFH. A free graphic design software is an awesome solution when you're starting out your new business. I get it, I remember when I used to try to save a few bucks and do it myself. In fact, I was always trying to do everything myself, and I went a long way with a free graphic design software. My personal favorite free software when I first realized I had to put some images on my site, banner ads, and other online profile was Microsoft Paint. I know, it sounds ridiculous to anyone in the graphic design industry, but for me, it was great. I was able to use it, I was able to draw shapes, add caption on top of all my images, and I was able to resize them and all. It was super easy and straightforward. Oh, and oh yes, I can't forget about the famous print screen button on my keyboard. When you see something you like, you simply press print screen, and whatever you see on your desktop will be copied onto your computer's clipboard. Then you can go into your free graphic design software and paste the image. Once in there, you can easily play around with it. And from my understanding, the equivalent of Paint for Mac is called Paintbrush. It's kind of the equivalent of Microsoft Paint, but for Mac, basically. Keep in mind that these free graphic design software are very basic in nature that have limits on the creativity you can have. But if you want to go pro or just have more options like working with layers, color correction, masks, and a whole slew of other options, then Adobe Photoshop is by far the number one software on the market right now. I now personally use Photoshop, as once I order something from a designer, I ask for the PSD files, and then I can go in and tweak things on demand. Basically, if I want to change something, I just go in and modify it, like change the text or change the product name or whatever. That's not too complicated. It's mainly with layers, but it's pretty simple and easy to use once you grasp that concept. The perfect example for this is my YouTube thumbnail images. You know, the one that you see on all my videos? Once I've created my video, I open my main thumbnail template and just change the text layer to give the new title. That's it, nothing else. I keep it really simple. You can see it behind the scenes of my day at work, and at about the 6 minute mark, you can see what I'm talking about. What I like about Photoshop is that there's a lot of tutorials and action scripts available online, specifically tailored to that software. Here's an awesome YouTube Photoshop playlist by Robert Baldwin I personally watched to get more tips and tricks on how to use Photoshop. It's actually pretty cool. So if you go on my site, you can get the link to that playlist actually. You can also get a free 30-day trial of Adobe Photoshop. Then it's like $10 a month. You can get more information on their price plan, but that's really good. I remember in the past, they didn't even have a monthly option. You could only buy the full software for like $700. Okay, so I did say free graphic design software, and Photoshop has a free trial. So it sort of counts, but it's not 100% free. But what about 100% free graphic design software? No worries, I got you covered. GIMP.org is an open source platform that's pretty much very comparable to Photoshop. Because it's an open source platform, it's 100% free, and you can download it and install it on your computer, and it works with layers, etc. It's super robust software. I just find that some of the tools and layouts are a little different or located in different menus. I'm pretty sure though that you can find lots of tutorials on how to use it on the internet. So finally, the last free graphic design software, but not the least, is a web-based client. Therefore, you don't have to install it on your computer. You can have access to it anywhere in the world as long as you have an internet connection, of course. This one is called pixlr.com, so that's pixlr.com. Again, the cool part is that you can open files and work with layers, adjust text, color correction, and again, lots of similar tools that Photoshop has. Since I have Photoshop, I didn't really have the need to use these other free graphic design software anymore. But at the beginning, when I first started out with a limited budget and all, those were my go-to tools. I also kept note of them just in case I'm traveling somewhere and for some reason I need to fix a banner or something like that, which is probably not going to happen. But anyways, these are some of my selection of free graphic design software tools that are a great complement for your business arsenal of tools. So what about you? How are you going to use these free graphic design software tools? Share your thoughts and comments down below, and thanks for watching this episode of CareerFH, Start Your Career From Home Today. If you want more tips and tricks on starting your own career from home, then come visit our blog at www.careerfh.com. There you'll find more in-depth videos and information to get you started and out the ground. Now, if you got value out of this video, please show us your appreciation by clicking on the like button, share it with your friends and family, and to get more videos like these, make sure you subscribe. Like always, have an awesome day, and cheers everybody!